Solun Decius served as an Astartes of the Death Guard Legion during the Great Crusade and Horus Heresy. The youngest member of Nathaniel Garro's 7th Great Company Command Squad, Solun would face the strange creature known as the Warsinger during the Compliance of the World of Istvaan III. His life would be saved during the melee by Battle Captain Nathaniel Garro, yet would result in Garro being severely wounded, preventing him and his command squad from being deployed during the Istvaan III Betrayal. Decius would flee the Betrayal of Istvaan III alongside his captain aboard the frigate Eisenstein, with the news of the betrayal from Emperor's Children Captain Saul Tarvitz. The Death Guard Loyalists would attempt to traverse to Holy Terra to bring word of the betrayal to the Emperor of Mankind. On board the vessel, the Loyalists would be confronted by the reanimated corpses of their treacherous brethren, with Solun being injured during the battle. Infected with the warp-twisted disease known as Nurgle's Rot, Decius would suffer untold maladies, pain and suffering as the Eisenstein journeyed to the Sol System. Upon the ship's arrival at the Moon of Luna, Decius would be confined within the Somnus Citadel under the protection and monitoring of the Sisters of Silence. Despite the best efforts of the Citadel's apothecaries, Decius would cry out for aid from the ruinous powers to take his pain away. Submitting fully to the thrall of the plague god, Nurgle, Solun Decius would be reborn as the demonic entity, the Lord of Flies. Escaping the Medicaid facility and slaying many Astartes and Sisters of Silence, the Lord of Flies would attempt to wreak havoc on the throne world. Yet Nathaniel Garro would stop the creature from fleeing, and upon the surface of Luna, the two would battle. Garro would slay the demon and cast its wretched soul into the Immaterium, yet the Lord of Flies would not remain idle for long. Confronting Garro 9 Terran standard years thereafter, prior to the Siege of Terra, infecting the walking city with swarms of flies, the demon would transform the populace into fly-infested zombies. Alongside his knight-errant brothers in arms, Garro would once more face his former ally. The creature would speak with the voice of Solun Decius, goading Garro with offers to rejoin the Death Guard with his inevitable defeat at the hands of the demon. Defeating the Chaos Incursion, the Lord of Flies would retreat after stating that the being known as Solun Decius had now been utterly consumed. Returning during the Battle of White Mountain, the Knight's Errant would once more face the Lord of Flies, revealing its host to be Garro's former ally and Loyalist Astartes, Apothecary Merrick Voyan. Garro would once more slay the body of a former friend. As the host body died, the Lord of Flies would move to possess the Knight Errant and former World Eater, Mesa Varan. Resolving to destroy himself with a brace of grenades, Varan would sacrifice his life in order to remain untainted by the corruption of the demon. As it sought to possess more Astartes, the Lord of Flies' defeat would seem impossible. Yet with the intervention of Malkador the Sigillite upon the slopes of the White Mountain, the wretched creature would be destroyed. Unleashing his psychic might to disintegrate the being into little more than ash, Malkador would warn the Knight's Errant that one day, such a being would spawn once again from the Immaterium. Though fortunately as of yet, the return of such a foul being has not been forthcoming.